Hello everyone, in this video we are going to study about lipoproteins. Lipoproteins are compound lipids, which is a complex of lipid plus proteins. We know that lipids are insoluble in water. To facilitate their transport, they are carried as lipoprotein in circulation. They are the macromolecular complexes of lipids and proteins. And they act as a transport vehicle. They contain specific carrier protein which is called as apoproteins. Apo means detached or separated, which means lipoprotein constitutes apoproteins along with lipids. Let's see the schematic structure of lipoprotein. It is made up of outer surface layer and a core. The outer surface layer is made up of amphipathic phospholipid. This phospholipid has a head which is polar in nature and it faces towards the aqueous medium and the tail faces towards the core, that is hydrophobic in nature. Along with the phospholipid, it has amphipathic free cholesterol. So outer surface layer is made up of phospholipid as well as free cholesterol. And there is peripheral apoprotein is present, for example ApoC. And this one is the integral apoprotein. This is the inner core, which is non-polar in nature and it is made up of cholesterol ester and triacylglycerol. So in the structure of lipoprotein, the inner core is mainly made up of non-polar lipid, which is surrounded by polar, that is amphipathic molecules like phospholipids and free cholesterol. What are the different classes of lipoproteins? Based on the electrophoresis of serum lipoproteins, they are classified as first chylomicrons, second VLDL, that is very low density lipoprotein, which is also called as pre-beta lipoprotein. Third is low density lipoprotein, which is called as beta lipoprotein. Fourth is HDL, that is high density lipoprotein, which is also called as alpha lipoprotein. Free fatty acids are also considered as one of the class of lipoprotein, but it cannot be separated by electrophoresis. So depending on this electrophoresis, the lipoproteins are classified into four major classes: chylomicrons, VLDL, LDL, HDL. Now let's see the diagrammatic representation of lipoproteins, their characteristics and composition. The first lipoprotein is a chylomicron, which is largest in size and it contains highest percentage of triacylglycerol. The second is very low density lipoprotein, which is smaller as compared to chylomicrons and it is large in size. And it contains high triacylglycerol as compared to other lipids. The third one is LDL, which is small in size and it mainly consists of cholesterol. Highest cholesterol is present in LDL, that is low density lipoprotein. And the fourth is HDL, which is smallest in size and it mainly consists of protein. The highest proteins are present in HDL. And as we go from chylomicrons towards HDL, the density increases. Size decreases and density increases. Percentage of protein also increases. The percentage of protein in chylomicrons is least, while the percentage of protein in HDL is most. The diameter decreases as we go from chylomicrons to HDL, which means that chylomicrons are the largest in size while HDL is the smallest in size. Now let's see the lipid protein composition in various lipoproteins. The chylomicron has highest triacylglycerol, that is 83% of TAG, 7% phospholipid, 8% cholesterol and the least, that is 2% of apoproteins. VLDL has 50% TAG, 18% phospholipid, 22% cholesterol and 10% apoprotein. LDL has 10% triacylglycerol, 22% phospholipid, 46% cholesterol and 22% apoprotein. So it has highest cholesterol in it, while the high density lipoprotein has least triacylglycerol, that is just 8%, 20 to 30% of phospholipid, 10 to 30% of cholesterol and 30 to 60% of protein, that is the highest percentage of protein. Now let's talk about lipoproteins and their functions and the associated apoproteins along with their functions. The apoproteins mainly act as a structural component of lipoproteins and they recognize the cell membrane surface receptors as well as they activate the enzymes involved in lipoprotein metabolism. Chylomicrons are synthesized in intestine. It is associated with the apoprotein ApoB48, which is required for chylomicron formation. It is also associated with apoprotein C2 in the circulation, and the function is activation of lipoprotein lipase. Apoprotein E is also associated with this lipoprotein, and the function is this ApoE acts as a ligand for LDL receptor or LRP, that is the LDL receptor related protein, and this is responsible for chylomicron remnant uptake in the liver. When chylomicron is synthesized in the intestine, it is associated with only B48 and it is called as nascent chylomicron. When it comes into circulation, it gets apoprotein C2 and E from HDL and then it becomes mature chylomicron. The function of chylomicron is that it carries exogenous, that is dietary triacylglycerol, from intestine to the peripheral tissues for utilization like skeletal muscle and adipose tissue. Very low density lipoprotein, that is VLDL, it is synthesized from liver and it consists of apoprotein B100, ApoB100. This ApoB100 acts as a ligand for LDL receptors on liver and peripheral cells. C2, which has a function of activation of lipoprotein lipase. ApoE, it is a ligand for LDL receptors and LRP, that is LDL receptor related protein, which is required for IDL and LDL uptake by liver. The function of VLDL is it carries endogenous triacylglycerol from liver to peripheral tissues for utilization, and the peripheral tissues are skeletal muscle and adipose tissues. Low density lipoprotein. VLDL is associated with three apoproteins, ApoB100, ApoE and ApoC2. In the circulation, VLDL remnant is formed, which is also called as IDL or intermediate density lipoprotein, which is associated with two apoprotein, ApoB100 and ApoE. Later, there is formation of LDL, that is low density lipoprotein, which has only ApoB100 as a apoprotein. What is the function of this ApoB100? It is involved in LDL receptor recognition. It is involved in the direct binding of LDL particles to LDL receptor. It is the structural protein of VLDL, IDL and LDL. And what is the function of LDL? It carries cholesterol from liver to peripheral tissues. And it is also called as bad cholesterol. It increases the risk of atherosclerosis. High density lipoprotein is synthesized from both intestine and liver as lipid poor molecule, that is ApoA1, which is also called as pre-beta HDL. Later on, it becomes discoidal and it has ApoC2 and ApoE along with ApoA1, and then it becomes spherical in shape and it is called as mature HDL. And this ApoA1 activates the enzyme LCAT, which is lecithin cholesterol acyl transferase. It is the repository of ApoC2 and ApoE. The function of HDL is to carry cholesterol from peripheral tissues to liver. It decreases the risk of atherosclerosis, and that's why it is also called as good cholesterol. Let's summarize the topic lipoproteins. They are macromolecular complexes of lipid plus proteins. They are compound lipids. The first lipoprotein is chylomicrons. It is synthesized in intestine. It is associated with three apoproteins, ApoB100, C2 and ApoE. It has highest percentage of triacylglycerol. The function of chylomicrons is to carry dietary or exogenous triacylglycerol from intestine to peripheral tissues. The second lipoprotein is VLDL. It is synthesized in liver. It is associated with three apoproteins, ApoB100, C2 and E. The function of VLDL is to carry endogenous triacylglycerol from liver to peripheral tissues. The third lipoprotein is LDL. It is synthesized in circulation from VLDL. It has only one apoprotein, that is ApoB100, and it has highest percentage of cholesterol. The function of LDL is to carry cholesterol to peripheral tissues. It increases the risk of atherosclerosis, and that's why it is called as bad cholesterol. HDL is synthesized both in intestine and liver. It is associated with apoprotein A1 and it is a repository of ApoC2 and ApoE. It carries cholesterol from peripheral tissues to liver, which is also called as reverse cholesterol transport. It decreases the risk of atherosclerosis, and that's why it is called as good cholesterol.